I'm Rick with TGW.com, and this is the new line of GT drivers from Titleist. It's my intent to tell you who's going to want to try one of these drivers. I'm going to go over the differences between the three. I got to hit this particular driver. I'll go over my experiences, and then I'll touch on just a little bit of the key technology and features that go into this great new lineup from Titleist. Titleist is introducing three drivers to the new GT line. The GT2 is designed with the highest MOI. It's going to provide maximum forgiveness while not sacrificing any performance. The GT3 is going to be your most tunable driver, designed for players who are really looking to dial in a specific shot shape, or they have a really consistent shot location on the club face and they want to put the mass behind that location. This is the GT4. It is designed typically for higher club head speed players, but players specifically who want to reduce their spin rates. This is Titleist's most aggressive spin reducing driver. Listed are the specifications for the new GT4 driver. You can see there are three different loft options available, starting at 8 degrees, going by 1 degree increments up to 10. Remember that each of these Titleist drivers has Titleist SureFit system in the hosel, and players can adjust the loft and lie up to 16 different unique settings. I got to hit the 9-degree version of the GT4 with the Mitsubishi Tensai Black Graphite Shaft and the Titleist 360 Universal Standard Stock Rubber Grip. But remember, TGW.com will happily accommodate any of your custom requests. My first impressions when getting to hit all of the new GT lineup from Titleist was that these are very Titleist traditional. They have a very similar look and feel to Titleist products of the past. So very traditional when it comes to the shape, and very traditional in the setup. All of these drivers set up nice and square. The GT4 does have the smallest footprint of the three drivers. When it comes to feel, very consistent to Titleist. I would say if you've hit a Titleist product as of recent, the last few years, it's gonna give you a similar solid feel. I was swinging this driver on average, pretty typical for me, at 101 miles an hour. I was getting an average ball speed of 143. I was launching the 9-degree driver with a slight ascending blow at 14 degrees, getting the lowest spin rate of all three drivers at only 1,700 RPMs of spin. That was giving me a very penetrating trajectory at 80 feet maximum height, a very shallow descent angle of only 32 degrees, an average carry distance of 250 yards, and with modest rollout, about 270 yards average total. To talk about the technology that goes into the new GT4 driver from Titleist, first of all, again, this is the lowest spinning driver, and it's for players who are losing distance because they're spinning the ball at 3,000 RPMs or above. GT4 also offers adjustability in the forward or aft position with this sole weight. Players can put the weight forward to really dramatically reduce spin, or for more stability and a higher MOI or more forgiveness, players can move that weight back to the aft position. The GT4 drivers feature a seamless thermoform crown, split mass construction for a higher MOI, advanced aerodynamics to help players pick up a little bit of club head speed for longer drives, and a speed ring variable face thickness that's gonna help promote faster ball speeds across the face. So if less spin and longer drives sound like they might be a good fit for your game and you want to try the new GT4 driver from Titleist, go ahead. TGW.com offers a 30-day mulligan buyback on any standard stock order and up to 90 days when you configure this custom GT4. Exceptional low spin performance. This is the new GT4 driver from Titleist. Check it out. Check out our other product review videos at TGW.com.